What's up, you fine ladies and gents? I realized a few weeks ago that I'm 31. That means I'm old as hell. No, in all seriousness, listen. I get a lot of emails from people and they act like life is over at 30. Now, in this video, I want to share being 31, the things I wish I knew before 30. Because now that I'm old and crusty, I guess I have wisdom or something like that. I hope this helps you. These are the five things I wish I knew before 30. What's up, guys? Alex Hine here, author of the book Master the Day. P.S. Did you see that new sexy cover? Check it out, all right? Now, listen, the first thing that I wish I knew before I turned 30 is that at 30, your life does not end. You know, average life expectancy of humans now is like 80-something. People talk to me and they think they have to have everything figured out by 30. Like the partner, the job, six figures, travel to 30 countries by 30. All these arbitrary goals. And it's like, okay, let's say you're making 50K doing what you enjoy by 30. That's great. That's better than most people. Let's say you're dating someone that's pretty close to what you want by 30. That's great. Let's say you just get one of those goals, one of those big rocks. That's great. Like, your life is not done at 30. I mean, I'm 31 and I'm only now having even a little bit of financial success doing work I love. But it's progressively gotten better every single year. Now I'm doing better, even easier, with less stress. And next year is going to be the same thing, even better, more fun, less stress. Better, more fun, less stress. Like, your life, as long as you're focusing on growth, your life is going to continue to get better every year. It's this odd, arbitrary thing, like, after college, your life's over. It's not how life works. If you focus on life getting better each year it'll get better. There's almost no upper limit for how good your life can get. Think about that. The second habit I want you to think of here is that deep ruts are already worn by 30. This is kind of interesting because one of my favorite quotes is by Earl Nightingale, and it says, "A rut is just a grave with the ends kicked out." So a rut is just like a grave. It's done. It's over. It's the same thing with the ends extended forever, your whole life. You know, I have friends now at 30, 31, 30, 40, 50 pounds overweight from the couple beers a night they've been doing since 24. I have friends married and divorced already. I have friends that are married, divorced, and remarried since 30. I have friends that are in the same job since 24, maybe capped out on their income, 70K or so, 60, 70, 80K. Now they're going to do the same crap until they're 60 years old, 65. The reality is that by 30, many ruts are already worn, which is crazy because it's so young. And if you don't consciously think about taking care, good care of your health, financial life, always improving, always upgrading. Career, are you doing what you love? If not, don't give up. Are you with the person that you want to be with and not, I just married him or her because I'm 30 and I'm getting old? That's really important. Do not settle for something as important as a marriage or a career. Those are things you're going to have to deal with your whole life. And if they're not right, you're screwed. Habit number three. If you have not found work you love yet, do not give up. Because it gets harder as you get older. Now look, the good thing about if you're in your 20s watching this is you have all this leeway to play and experiment. Like, I bought a one-way ticket to China. Who the hell does that? A 22-year-old is who? Like, you can start 15 companies, they can all fail, and at 30 you still have plenty of time to keep trying that. The big thing though is I believe that the two big rocks in life you have to get right as best you can are work and love, like Freud said. And love especially. Because the person you date or marry is probably going to be the most important life decision for your happiness or your resulting depression. And I think these are really, really, really important things to focus on. But guess what? I'm 31. I didn't find work I loved until 29. And I was working my ass off from 22. My only focus in my life from 22 on was how do I find work I love that can support me and the family? It took 7 years. So imagine people who aren't even really all in trying to pursue work they care about. Good luck. Like, that is something you should be focusing on. Because when you have to pay your rent, when you have bills, when you get that new car and it's a $500 a month lease payment, and your rent is $1,500 a month, and you have student debt payments for $1,000 a month, you're living on a poverty salary, making 40K. You have no money. And then what happens when you throw on two kids now? Huh? And then your partner decides to stay home because someone's got to take care of the kids. Or you put your kids in daycare and it's $3,000 a month. Find work you love and make that a priority. Find or build work you love. Work in the after hours after your full-time job. Work a part-time job to build the company you want. Make it an absolute priority because your happiness has to be a priority in your work. The fourth habit here is that sometimes you have to struggle and it doesn't mean you're off course. The big thing that annoyed me, that annoyed the hell out of me, honestly, was in my early 20s, I thought that, you know, being an intuitive, I would just like follow my intuition and it would lead me to my magical path for fulfillment and enjoyment. But it didn't happen. Like, it didn't happen for years. And when I started businesses and I got jobs, none of them were what I was really passionate about. And it confused me because I thought, maybe I'm living my life wrong or I'm doing something wrong. If nothing is speaking to me in my life, I must not be following my intuition, right? I think in life, though, it's cyclical, like chaos and order, chaos and order. You feel like you're Chicken Little, the world's ending, and then a year later, it's all fine and dandy. Like, 1 year before, you're with the worst person you've ever dated and you hate your life. Next year, you could be with your dream person. And I think it's okay, but you have to understand these cyclical things, order and chaos, are natural fluctuations. Sometimes in life, you have to push. One of my mentors said, like, you want to, of course, go with the flow whenever you can. Whenever you can flow in a relationship and it's easy and it works. Or you flow in a job and it's easy and it works. But guess what? A lot of the time in life, it doesn't. And you want to exercise that muscle of will where you train yourself to swim upstream. Because if you get used to that, when it's downstream, life is such cake. Like for me, it is a cakewalk now in my financial and my career life. I love it. But it wasn't the case for most of my adult life. The fifth habit here is that life will get better every year if you get better continually. So this is a weird thing in American culture where people are like, you know, once you go to college, those are the best years of your life, live it up. And after that, it's all downhill, as if 21 is your most fun year of your life. And then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then it's all going straight to hell. Makes no sense. Like, why would you not have more fun every year? Like, okay, you have more responsibilities. You got to pay your rent. You may have kids and a family. You may struggle financially. You may not have time off. But you can change almost all of those things and improve your life. I know for a fact the people I respect the most actually describe their 20s as the worst decade of their life. Because that's when they were figuring things out and building their career and doing all this stuff. Finding and dating bad partners to, you know, to get that contrast to learn where the good ones are. And that to me was so inspiring, and I instantly knew it to be true because every year since 22, since I found personal development, my life has gotten way better. Like, way better. Like, consider that I wasn't in a good relationship till 25. That lasted 5 years. So if I was expecting any relationship before 25 to be the best, I would have been screwed. If I expected the most money I would have earned doing the most enjoyable work, I would have been screwed. Every year, my life gets better because every year I think about how to make my life better. How could I have more fun at work, have cooler friends, date more amazing women, or go in deeper with the woman I'm dating, travel more, like work less, stress less, work more on what I love. Your life will get better if your focus, your singular focus, is how do I get it better? And it seems like a lot of the people who peak later in life, the 20s suck as they figure things out. The 30s, 40s, and beyond are exponentially better. I know a lot of my family members that struggled young, and they say 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, those were all the best years of their life. And for me, I certainly can see that probably coming true, because right now, every year, it's gotten better and better. So don't believe the lie that it's over when you're done with college, because if you're living your life that way, then I feel bad for you, because it probably is over. All right, guys, I hope that video helps. It all revolves around the same old shtick I do here every week, which is that if you focus on growth and consciously designing your life, why wouldn't it get better every year? It should. So I hope that helps. Before you go, comment there below and let me know for you, if you're 20, what do you wish you knew by 20? If you're 30, what do you wish you knew by 30? And if you're 50, 60, 70, 80, what do you wish you knew over the last decade of your life? Comment there below. All right, guys, best way to stay in touch is to watch the last video here and here and grab my free personal development and weight loss challenge at modernhealthmonk.com/YouTube. It's also in the description box there below. It is a free 7-day starter weight loss challenge, and that is the best way to stay in touch with me as well.